Welcome to Halibut Point State Park, located in Rockport, Massachusetts. Originally, this land was used by the Pawtucket Indians to provide food. The area has plenty of fruit, fish, animals, and granite. Though Samuel Gott and other early settlers attempted to use this area as farmland, in the 1800s this park was opened as the Babson Farm Granite Quarry. The process of quarrying the 440 million-year-old granite from the area began in the 1840s. And continued until 1929, when the quarry was forced to close due to depression increase in concrete. During its time as a quarry, Halibut Point produced granite on a small scale in the 1840s. This quickly changed when the area was purchased by the Rockport Granite Company and extended the business. Though granite was first quarried in the late 1700s, the demand for it increased greatly in the 1800s. The industry has grown and now has over 430,000 manufacturers and suppliers. In 1885, a quarryman averaged $18 a week to cut 1,000 pouring stones. When the granite quarry opened, many of the workers were immigrants from Sweden and Finland. Quarrying granite gave the immigrants a place to work and provide for their families, in the process improving the economy. Granite is a mixture of feldspar, quartz, and other minerals, which is the reason for the color variations. The particular granite found at Halibut Point is of high quality and fine grain, and is also harder than most granite. It is mainly used in monuments, countertops, tombstones, bridges, and buildings. Examples of granite from Halibut Point are found all over America, including Longfellow Bridge in Cambridge, Massachusetts, Holland Tunnel in New York, and banks in Iowa, Ohio, and New Orleans. The building of such places also opened up opportunities for jobs. Workers for these jobs demanded rights, which gave way to unions. The workers' union at Halibut Point was one of the first among Cape Ann residents, created shortly after the textile industry union. Unions gave a sense of security among the workers and gave the people more rights. As a result, more workers were comfortable working in the quarry. At its peak, the quarry averaged 800 workers, which in turn produced more granite. Granite is cut into blocks, one cubic foot weighing 168 pounds. There were originally 30 different sizes of stones, but it was narrowed down to three. To cut these stones, first, chalk lines were drawn where the holes were to be drilled. Secondly, a tracer would cut a groove, which would be cut using a drilling hammer. After the dust was cleaned out, half rounds and wedges were inserted and hit with a sledgehammer. The process has gone through modifications as the tools change in advance. Halibut Point also demonstrates the advancement of technology. While quarrying, it is a constant struggle to remove water from the area the workers are cutting blocks. When the quarry first opened, this was done using bucket brigades. As technology advanced, the bucket brigades advanced to a steam-powered pump. It advanced even further to an oxygen-powered pump. Though when the quarry closed, it was no longer pumped out and has since filled with water. Another example of the advancement of technology is demonstrated in the process the men use to move the granite. The process was originally a block and tackle system using a derrick. Indentations in the rock known as dog holes were used to hold in a hook which carried the granite. It took 12 men to move, or oxen were used. This advanced to a steam-powered operation, which was much safer. Halibut Point is one example of the impact the granite industry, workers' unions, and the advancement of tools and technology in Essex County.
Here are some European immigrants quarrying at Halibut Point